Tuesday, 30th March 2021. We like sheep have gone astray, we have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our Heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts, that we may obtain forgiveness by his infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in his presence to give thanks for the great benefits we have received at his hands, to declare his most worthy praise, to hear his holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much to devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Psalm 147. Praise the Lord, for it is a good thing to sing praises unto our God. Indeed, a joyful and pleasant thing it is to be thankful. The Lord builds up Jerusalem and gathers together the outcasts of Israel. He heals those who are broken in heart and binds up their wounds. He counts the number of the stars and calls them all by their names. Great is our Lord and great is his power. Indeed, his wisdom is infinite. The Lord lifts up the meek and brings the ungodly down to the ground. O sing unto the Lord with thanksgiving, sing praises with the harp unto our God, who covers the heavens with clouds and prepares rain for the earth, and makes the grass to grow upon the mountains and plants for the use of men, who gives food to the cattle and feeds the young ravens that call upon him. He has no pleasure in the strength of a horse, neither does he delight in any man's strength. But the Lord's delight is in those who fear him and put their trust in his mercy. Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion, for he has made strong the bars of your gates and has blessed your children within you. He makes peace in your borders and fills you with the finest of wheat. He sends forth his commandment upon the earth, and his word runs very swiftly. He gives snow like wool and scatters the white frost like ashes. He casts forth his ice like crumbs. Who is able to abide his frost? He sends out his word and melts them. He blows with his wind and the waters flow. He declares his word unto Jacob, his statutes and ordinances unto Israel. He has not dealt so with other nations, neither have they knowledge of his laws. Praise the Lord. Psalm 148. Praise the Lord. O praise the Lord of heaven. Praise him in the heights. Praise him, all you angels of his. Praise him, all his hosts. All his host. Praise him, sun, moon. Praise him, all you stars of light. Praise him, all you heaven, highest heavens, and your waters that are above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he spoke the word, and they were made. He commanded, and they were created. He has made them stand fast forever and ever. He has given them a law which shall not be broken. Praise the Lord upon the earth, you sea monsters and all deeps. Fire and hail, snow and fog, wind and storm, fulfilling his word. Mountains and all hills, fruitful trees and all cedars, beasts and all cattle, creeping things and birds of the air, kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the world, young men and maidens, old men and children together. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name only is excellent, and his praise above heaven and earth. He shall exalt the horn of his people. All his faithful shall praise him. The children of Israel, the people who are near him, praise the Lord. Psalm 149. Praise the Lord. O sing unto the Lord a new song. Let the congregation of the faithful praise him. Let Israel rejoice in the one who made him. And let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praises unto him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord has pleasure in his people and gives victory to those who are oppressed. Let the faithful be joyful with glory. Let them rejoice upon their beds. Let the praises of God be in their mouth, and a two-edged sword in their hands, to inflict vengeance on the nations and to rebuke the peoples, to bind their kings in chains and their nobles with links of iron, that they may execute judgment upon them. As it is written, this is the honor of all his servants. Praise the Lord. Psalm 150. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord in his holiness. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him for his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him upon the lute and harp. Praise him with the trembles and dances. Praise him upon the string and pipe. Praise him with the resounding cymbals. Praise him with the loud cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. O praise the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus, beginning with the 37th chapter, the first verse. Bezalel made the ark of acacia wood. 2 cubits and a half was its length, 1 cubit and a half its breadth, and 1 cubit and a half its height. And he overlaid it with pure gold inside and outside, and made a molding of gold around it. And he cast for it 4 rings of gold for its 4 feet, 2 rings on its one side and 2 rings on its other side. And he made poles of acacia wood, and overlaid them with gold, and put the poles into the rings of the sides of the ark to carry the ark. And he made a mercy seat of pure gold, 2 cubits and a half was its length, and a cubit and a half its breadth. And he made 2 cherubim of gold. He made them of hammered work on the 2 ends of the mercy seat, 1 cherub on the one end, and 1 cherub on the other end. Of 1 piece with the mercy seat, he made the cherubim on its 2 ends. The cherubim spread out their wings above, overshadowing the mercy seat with their wings, with their faces one to another toward the mercy seat where the faces of were the faces of the cherubim. He also made the table of acacia wood, 2 cubits its length, a cubit its breadth, and a cubit and a half its height. And he overlaid it with pure gold and made a molding of gold around it. And he made a rim around it, a handbreadth wide, and made a molding of gold around the rim. He cast for it 4 rings of gold and fastened the rings of the 4 corners at its 4 legs, close to the frame where the rings were the rings, as holders for the poles to carry the table. He made the poles of acacia wood to carry the table and overlaid them with gold. And he made the vessels of pure gold that were to be on the table, its plates and dishes for incense, and its bowls and flagons with which to pour drink offerings. He also made the lampstand of pure gold. He made the lampstand of hammered work, its base, its stem, its cup, its calyxes, and its flowers were of 1 piece with it. And there were 6 branches going out of its sides, 3 branches of the lampstand out of one side of it, and 3 branches of the lampstand out of the other side of it. 3 cups made like almond blossoms, each with calyx and flower on one branch, and 3 cups made like almond blossoms, each with calyx and flower on the other branch. So for the 6 branches going out of the lampstand. So for the 6 branches going out of the lampstand. And on the lampstand itself were 4 cups made like almond blossoms with their calyxes and flowers, and a calyx of 1 piece with it under each pair of the 6 branches going out of it. Their calyxes and their branches were of 1 piece with it. The whole of it was a single piece of hammered work of pure gold. And he made its 7 lampstands and its tongs and its trays of pure gold. He made it and all its utensils out of a talent of pure gold. He made the altar of incense of acacia wood. Its length was a cubit and its breadth was a cubit. It was square, and 2 cubits was its height. Its horns were of 1 piece with it. He overlaid it with pure gold, its top and around its sides and its horns. And he made a molding of gold around it, and made 2 rings of gold on it under its molding on 2 opposite sides of it, as holders for the poles with which to carry it. And he made the poles of acacia wood and overlaid them with gold. He made the holy anointing oil also, and the pure fragrant incense blended as by the perfumer. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Seek the Lord while he wills to be found. Call upon him when he draws near. Let the wicked forsake their ways, and the evil ones their thoughts, and let them turn to the Lord, and he will have compassion, and to our God he will richly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as rain and snow fall from the heavens and return not again, but water the earth, bringing forth life and giving growth, seed for sowing and breath for eating, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish that which I have purposed, and prosper in that for which I sent it. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Mark, beginning with the first chapter, the first verse. The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ by this, the Son of God, as it is written in Isaiah the prophet, "Behold, I send my messenger before your face, who will prepare your way? The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight." John appeared baptizing in the wilderness and proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And all the country of Judea and all Jerusalem were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and wore a leather belt around his waist and ate locusts and wild honey. And he preached, saying, "After me comes he who is mightier than I, the strap of whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And when he came up out of the water, immediately he saw the heavens being torn open and the Spirit descending on him like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my beloved Son, with you I am well pleased." The Spirit immediately drove him out into the wilderness, and he was in the wilderness 40 days being tempted by Satan, and he was with the wild animals, and the angels were ministering to him. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed. For he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers Abraham and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord have mercy, Christ have mercy, Lord have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, O Lord. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, O Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may be bound together by your Holy Spirit and the communion of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all your saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ, we entreat you, O Lord. O Lord our God, whose blessed Son gave his back to be whipped and did not hide his face from shame and spitting, give us grace to accept joyfully the sufferings of the present time, confident of the glory that will be revealed through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Lighten our darkness, we beseech you, O Lord, and by your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another, your abounding grace may increase among us through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. O most mighty and merciful God, in this time of grievous sickness, we flee to you for comfort. Deliver us, we beseech you, from our peril. Give strength and skill to all those who minister to the sick. Prosper the means made use of for their cure, and grant that, perceiving how frail and uncertain our life is, we may apply our hearts unto that heavenly wisdom which leads to eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, whose blessed Son, Jesus Christ, went about doing good and healing all manner of sickness and disease among the people, continue in our hospitals his gracious work among us, especially in this time of plague and pandemic. Console and seal the sick. Grant to the physicians, nurses, and assisting staff wisdom and skill, diligence and patience. Prosper their work, O Lord, and send down your blessing upon all who serve the suffering. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen.